Tony Hawk's Underground Pro reviews. We got something that we have to review on. So we go first to create a skater. We just look up to the stuff and create some skaters that you can take a look. Create your new avatar. Like so, as you make a character, you change the colors or anything like this. Like you could do. But I have to just say that you can switch, change your avatar, whatever it goes. But nothing new, it's not mod yet. But other stuff you could do is change your board, just change your nets, change your trunks, and even the wheels. Wheels are actually cool, the colors are actually optional. You could even scale yourself and size it up, and then you're finished. That's how you scale yourself. Well, I know. This is really cool. Scaling the board, everything. You put your name or custom name, what your name is, or your custom avatar, your age, even your downtown place. Like, you can actually do it. I just noticed we can do it. Anyways, let's head skating. We got some things to do. Look at the levels. You pick this. And here we are. We're in college. College, don't we? I really suppress this college, it's really nice. When this level mod is built with this mod, it's always free for both. But I really, really skate in this mod, Tony Hawk's Underground Pro. This mod gives you a lot of things to do. You can actually explore different levels from other Tony Hawk's Pro Skater games that's actually ported from it. Because the game is actually ported from Xbox versions. You can actually select different levels. You got a bunch of levels that are ready to go for different games of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater series. Like Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2, Project 8, or yeah. I think we don't have Proving Grounds, so we jump in Vancouver doing some kickflips. We can actually visit some Tony Hawk's Underground 1. Of course, this is previous. It's not a PC port, it's actually an Xbox port. That's what Morton tells about, and Quaz is actually saying that they actually make this game completely better, well, and kind of well to give the players experience play online. But what the hell is two players? Two players is not in the game. Why? Because the two players was no longer because of the issue. But I'll be sure that we're allowed to play horse because horse is not actually included in the game. Because horse is fun when Bobby and Jack are just playing horse for every different Tony Hawk's game. But this game, Tony Hawk's Underground Pro, that we never get the chance to play Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 3 level because it's only single player for just Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. Since going to New Orleans, do some damn warring. You can do wars around here. That's when you give players abilities to just do something after you grind yourself. Well, what the heck? You grind. Anything like that. I know. You can just do whatever you take to try to put into spot pressure to your high scores. You can push your high scores in and down. Saying this level is from Tony Hawk's American Wasteland. Ported from the Xbox. That's right. Xbox. That's right. But it wasn't ported from the PC version because that PC version has the same thing, same level, or same thing or something. Like, it's ported. You can play like Eastside Los Angeles or anything else. Van Park. And including Tony Hawk's Tony Hawk's Underground Mix, like Tony Hawk's Underground 2 Mix, like Kyoto, Casino, Atlanta, and Kyoto. I mean Santa Cruz, that's right. But sometimes Santa Cruz is truly missing some secrets. Like secret, you know about the Santa Cruz. The Santa Cruz has been removed from the secret area that was present in Tony Hawk's Underground 2 Remix. First things, you don't want to lose anything. People, new people is new to the series, like New York, where Atlanta, it wasn't even playing any horse. Because Atlanta was where it been removed, because the developers removed it to the PC version. You can't play Atlanta for 2 things. Like Bobby and Jack are having issues that we can't play this level. Or can't play here on this level in Tonex level on the going mix. Because that's why? Because Tonex, the PSP Illuminator crashes when you start a level. Like training in Santa Cruz. As well as the Mexican level. I don't know what that is. I can't pronounce that name well, but yeah. Atlanta's fun to play. And some features and pain. Well, Atlanta is nice and cut. Now we also include Tony Hawk on Project 8. That's really sweet. You can play Tony Hawk on Project 8. That's cool. Project 8 is really nice. You can play it and have fun. Tony Hawk's Underground 2 in Project 8. But we didn't seem to have discussable plot like Tony Hawk's Underground. I mean, Tony Hawk's Moving Ground. That's right. Tony Hawk's Moving Ground. Okay, we have finally first time play ever, it's Annie's Room from Disney's Extreme Skate. That's right, you skate in Annie's Room. That's the only single level. Oh, we still see some unreleased levels like, fair enough, from Tarzan. The ship, that's right. The ship is where the Tarzan land is just all about. I'm gonna give you a hint tip what we could do. And then, I guess we could play online. Like, I'm playing by myself. There's a lot of settings, cheats, or whatever you could do. Set up your game, or anything. You can even set up your level to change whatever you want. Anything. Right now, I'm playing Oil Rig. Oil Rig is kind of the port from the Xbox Special Edition from Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 3. Unlikely, Tony Hawk's Rec Points doesn't have that too. But it adds some new features at the bottom. Well, not being real for anything. But something that you don't want to exit, Oil Rig. You play Oil Rig early, like American Wasteland. Oil Rig is actually Xbox exclusive for Xbox. That has been played for PC version. Like, watch this. I was gonna start a game like Trick Attack, where I gotta put 30 seconds and then start Trick Attack. Where I finish my combos, I start landing or anything. Well, I just broke something in the online. Maybe I glitched or something. But nothing could stop this. But when I fail, I just got a new point. Well, if you did enjoy this game, be happy to rate this thing. And I'll rate this thing 10 out of 10 because it has a bunch of levels that are inside Tony Hawk's Underground Pro. If you want to play some more games, see me and you can say it. Goodbye.